Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity! As brought to you by my amazing supporters over on Patreon, and as per usual, we are just starting up here with a screen of the loading variety. And apparently they're going on about barbarians being well suited for groups of enemies. Oh hey! Wow. Man, they gave me no time on that as soon as it finished loading. Hey, guess what? Combat. Sporlings. Alright, so we've got, I guess, the Pillars of Eternity version of Myconids. Anybody who's played... See, I want to say there were a bunch of Myconids in Icewind Dale, and then there are Myconids, I think, in Baldur's Gate 2 as well. I always just remember them being a huge pain in the ass. But here, at least those don't appear to be too much of a threat. Alright, so what do we got going on here? Oh, more Sporlings. Oh, and traps. I assume that's this thing. Let's go ahead, guys. So are there any other encounters that I can just trigger? Let's just get this all out in one. Yeah, hey. Oh, a Mangpuigra. Menpuigra? Maybe a Greater Puigra? Yeah, her and a Loth can have at each other. Let's see how this goes. My money's on the wizard. Yeah, I think he's pretty well solved that problem. Come on, tentacles. Yeah, there you go. Yep. All right. Della Karak, go ahead and see what's in here. What do we got? Archer's gloves, plus 10% range damage. I will give those to Goldleaf. I don't know if she will use them, but I can certainly check. Let's see, what is she? Would that be here? Is that bracers? Yes, that is bracers of deflection. I'm gonna give her the damage, because realistically, she's honestly not attacked too much, and when she is, the braces of deflection aren't gonna save her. All right, so this is just a dead end. Come up this way a little ways.
You gotta see this.
I wonder if this is a secret wall, guys. I mean, the Devil of Karak noticed something. She's discovered something, but I don't see anything.
Let's go.
Oh, it's right in front of my damn face. Here, can you guys like, no, can't really. Here, pull back. Pull back. Oh, okay, I guess we can just do this. We've just got it kind of borked in here. Oh my God, everybody, no AI down here now. Come on. All right, there we go. Close enough. Whatever. Everybody gets AI again. Yeah. Part of me wishes that the secret doors were a little less obvious, but I can see how that could be a difficult thing to do. So I'm not gonna judge too harshly. A deer wooden charm belt. Thin, lightweight loop of tan leather has a small metal buckle bearing an engraving of a stag's head, a star, the symbol of the free Pelinate of the Deerwood. Alright, apart from the declaring the weirdo's loyalties, the belt carries a charm which grants fleeter passage over terrain. Unclear if the charm persists beyond the boundaries of the Deerwood. I would bet that it does, because I'd be surprised if they took the time to program that for, you know, random, like, expansions. Souls bound in eternity. Alright. Bones are partially corroded and coated with thick slime. Well, I'm curious, like, this seems to be it? Yeah. I wonder if this is something that we're maybe supposed to come back to at a later date. Goldleaf, you just, you know, not, you just hanging out down there? Come on, guys. What is this? Souls bound in eternity, yeah, I don't know. Maybe this is like the River of Souls or something. Who knows? I missed some mushrooms, though. Huh. Well, that was kind of a cool little side area. I'm certainly not averse to there just being little side areas like this that don't necessarily have a, I guess, a quest or anything tied to them. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm always up for side area exploration if it's going to make itself available to me. Pretty much regardless of the genre. Okay, so I think we're done here. So ideally, we can just area transition off the south side of the map here. I hope. No? No, yes, okay. Elmshore. I assume this is where we're going? At least we have to go through here. We're going to the Twin Elms, which I have a feeling... Yeah, so this is... Yeah, the Twin Elms is over here, so yeah. Why can't we just... Oh, there's mountains, I guess. Okay. So yeah, it looks like we're gonna have to kind of do Elmshore, and then it looks like we have a road leading down into Twin Elms, which looks to be a secondary town here. Ha! Yeah, sure. Well, let's do this high level. Because I don't want to trivialize the entirety of the game. If they can, like, make it a little bit more challenging, I'm okay with that, I guess. As much as I enjoy just steamrolling things, I think I would rather have a challenge. And I'm honestly really glad that they give me the opportunity to choose that. I'm worried about what it's going to do, but we'll see. Got some mushrooms. I do really like the maps in this game. Like, the area design is just really good. Part of me wishes that, like, doing something like this didn't require, like, a massive team of really good artists. Because, wow, okay, that is a group. Wait, so are these, all right, maybe they just increase enemy numbers. That might be what they're doing instead. Because, like, there's a lot of enemies. Have a law throw an ice ball in there, I guess. Some AoE going on. We have an Adragon. Adragon. Okay, I get it. It's Adra. Is it like a Gorgon, but Adra? I think it petrified Swell. Alright, I suppose I should have my back row do something, because, like, the devil's down here. Let's have Aloth come in and do some work. Let's get you healing yourself. What are you doing? Where are you even going? Quit that. Get yourself healed going. These two are both fine, I'm certain. Gold Leaf is paralyzed. Aloth. Oh, also paralyzed. Oh, and we may have aggroed further badness. All right, well, let's get this going then. Get some damage cooking. Heal yourself, heal yourself. Adair is just like impervious to everything because that's how he rolls.
My shot.
All right, get out of there. Oh, we lost the barbarian. Let's get her back on, let's get her back on her feet. And Aloth. And there's only like three of these things. It's this caster, I think, that's really screwing us up. See if we can maybe turn it into, oh, it's immune to being sheeped. That's troublesome. Get on it, get on it. No, kill. Gold Leaf. I could have her res, but it seems kind of unnecessary. Chain lightning cooking. Alright, I think the caster, yeah, the caster just got pasted. As soon as I turned a couple of the melees onto it, that portion of the fight was well and truly over.
Let's go.
Okay, so these things, I guess they're a little beefy. Like, that's okay. Like, that was a big fight. That felt like a really big fight. That was a lot of stuff going on there, so I don't feel too particularly bad about being kind of roughed up a little. Oh, and Adair wants to talk to us. Hey, Adair.
What do you want about Dear Woodens? They haven't met the problem yet that they couldn't solve by killing some scapegoats.
I don't disagree with you. You fight for people because you see something there that deserves defending. Even more so because someone you trust sees it too. And you turn around and they do something like this, and the person who made you want to help them is gone. Never fail to disappoint. They're doing what they think the gods want of them. It's nice that they mean well, but how can organized murder be their best guess? Although, come to think of it, maybe they just followed in Wadewin's example. He was purging his own long before Deerwood got the idea. Only he was purging because they weren't Aothisian enough. Aothisian? Yeah, I know. Jesus. Never thought I'd find myself missing the hospitality back home. Yeah, it's funny how that works. Okay, well, I saw more beetles over here. Jesus, there are just a lot of enemies out here. Part of me really does think that this is part of the difficulty, like, is that they cranked up enemy numbers. She just said something, I have no idea what it was, it didn't sound like English. here. Do some, like, debuff yawps. And you... interrupt enemies around the wheeler and leave them stunned. Sure. And I don't really know that the back row necessarily needs to do too much here. We'll drop a bless.
Leads the way. This is getting...
There. Your self-heal cooking on. We should be able to just melee here. You get away from my back row, forest trolls. I see you guys making your maneuvers. Don't make me. I'll like throw lightning bolts at you or something. These things are just like standing around. They're just hanging out. Whatever. And here, pitch a freebie fireball in there. There. Huh.
Hey.
Okay. I mean, if nothing else, like I was gonna say we're getting experience, but it does not look like we are getting experience for this. So I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. I'm not even gonna try to explain. I don't know what this game wants. Oh my god, another. Jeez, like these are just huge groups of enemies. Like this is. Just a. Lot of enemies. let's get. Yeah, let's get some debuffs cooking here. You get back, because otherwise you're gonna die. I guess we can just have him summon the tentacles. Okay, it looks like we're gonna start needing to actually use our buffs and stuff again here, guys. I don't know. Double Karak's gonna die again. There's really not a lot I can, do about that. She's just so fragile. I know I've mentioned it like countless times, but she is surprisingly hard to keep alive. Oh, Adair's stunned, or Aloth is stunned, rather. Let's see, this will heal. Pops and healing. She's in trouble, I think. I don't know why. Why are you not attacking any? Oh, you're dominated. Nice! Oh, Adair. You are my only hope. Maybe do an AoE stun slash interrupt. There's a druid among them. And that is just all kinds of horror. Alright, so he's casting, doing not a whole lot. Let's drop another heal. Zayn is the devil right here. Yeah, she's down. Alright. I mean, here, we can try getting a sleep spell, but I think all of these things are probably immune to it, if I had to guess. Yeah, pretty much. These are all elementals. Well, and apparently beetles. Freaking blights are back in town. What I want to know is... So they have DR6. Immune to slashing damage, alright. Earth blights are immune to slashing. Rain blights are immune to piercing. So we essentially want everybody using bludgeoning if possible. So Swell, you are just... Swell is just screwed. Get back over to your sword and board. She's also partially screwed. Yeah. And paralyzed. It's just a bad time all around. Let's have Swell do some healing here. I was gonna have Adair move down and maybe throw some magical death out there, but I don't think I'm gonna need him to. Yeah, I'd say we have this.
That's it.
There we go. Not bad. Like, these fights aren't... These are definitely not as hard as what I was bumping into in the White Marches, because they are less complicated fights. It's basically like, okay, it's just a group of things that are going to be a pain in the ass in the melee and a druid. It's not, Logafeth's paralyzing half my party and then just chain maiming them. I think I'm going to give Adair instead of damage versus flanked. I'm going to give him a heal multiplier. I think that'll be a little bit more useful to him. Because he has his passive healing, and I hope that would do something for him. Half asleep, a tide of deafening whispers assails you, chipping away at your senses and your mind's understanding of itself. The roar is louder with each passing night, the attacks more brazen, less confined to your subconscious. A familiar voice fights its way through the din, calling out to you.
Hey! Gotta stop it with that. Just about punched you to snap you out of it. You're saying things, but they weren't any words I ever heard. You're shaking so hard I thought you'd crack your spine.
Things haven't improved. My mind must be going.
So I noticed. I've woken you sooner, but I thought it'd be nice for you to be able to close your eyes a bit. Folks don't last long without sleep. You're twitchy these days. Reminds me of Meyerwald more than I'd like. Anything I can do, you just let me know. We're close on this one. Hang on a little longer. We'll get you fixed up.
Adair, you're a bro.
Sure.
What do we got here? A corpse with a fine warhammer, boots of stability, camping supplies, and some money. Nothing too interesting. I will take the camping supplies,
nice
though.
And
if nothing else, they replace the ones that I just used. I mean, apparently missed some bodies. How dare I miss loot? Okay. So, I mean, I'm comfortable with these fights. I'm not immediately regretting my choices, I'll put it that way. Find Brigandine, some gems, money, and a crossbow. Alright, random dead dude down by the river. I bet you that's a country song, and I keep hitting Alt to highlight things because, as I have mentioned, action RPGs and the Alt key go hand in hand. This looks like a dungeon right here, like there's even stairs down, and yet I cannot enter it. Oh, hey. All right, well, that's the primary target then, the Adragan in back. Okay, so I'm gonna... I love it, the casters are leading the goddamn party. You dicks. Oh my god. You're all terrible. Oh my lord, and there's the lightning-related death. All right, is that caster down? Yes, all right, so enemy caster is down at least. I think these thunderstorms might be from the rain blights. These things are probably immune to fire? I don't know. I'm gonna assume they are, but if I get a freebie fireball, we can do some science here. Maybe not? I can't tell. They're definitely weak to lightning, which Aloth can use because he has chain lightning and lightning bolt both. So that's
sure.
Noted. Okay, so let's kind of clear down the coastline. I think I'm just gonna follow the coast and we'll go from there. Some will-o-wisps, looks like they're getting ready with some lightning and another rain blight. Can I just like, God.
Hey.
Oh wow, alright, that's a bigger fight than I thought it was gonna be. A bunch of rain blights, will-o-wisps. Not terrible. But it's something that's probably worth investing in some. Chain lightning is just not as effective as I would like it to be.
So there you are.
I have no idea why that just played that. Why would that have played? That's very strange. That shouldn't have been playing. That's one of my... Yo, dog, you just got followed on Twitch sound effects. But I have none of that enabled for this, so I don't know. Actually, I don't need any healing in the front row. It's all in the back. It's so hard, like, with how intermixed everyone is here. Like, this is not a good place for just throwing fireballs and stuff. I can summon tentacles, I guess. Like, that's kind of my go-to with Aloth is...
How bad?
Is a fight going on? Can I not hit anything with AoEs? Tentacles!
I shall deal with this one.
No, don't.
I shall deal with this one.
Leave Goldleaf alone. She's just confused. She's still in her formative years. She doesn't know what she wants to do with her life. Don't judge her for not having picked a career yet. Jesus. Okay, a bunch of primal water, which I really don't have any use for, but okay. Oh, I see you. Come here. Settler's arrows. Let's see. Alright, so... Alright, so these are just Aedra pillars, apparently. Although, I gotta say, like, that... Like, there's a staircase right there. Come on, now.
Ain't that special?
Maybe. 158 coins? Not particularly. I'm pretty sure I've found more special in nooks and crannies in dungeons up to this point. Ogres! Holy shit! A lot of ogres! Alright, where's... Casters are in back. Ish. So, no, I don't want you to do your... Damn it! I don't want interdiction, although... Drop it. Well... I'm going to interdict them, because I think this is probably going to be decent. It can daze things, and it's against Will and their giants, which are dumb. So this should be hilarious. Assuming it works. Also, bees! Yeah, look at that! We just dazed, like... half of these things for 14 seconds. That's pretty good. I can also, I suppose, sleep the group of them, because I'm sure these things are just all kinds of susceptible to basically anything that requires, like, a will save. Yeah, look at that. That's some beauty right there. All right, let's get some group heals on. How long are these things down? They're down for 10 seconds. Oh, where's the Devil of Karak at? Can she... All right, he's down. She's going to murder this thing. I was going to say, like, she's going to just straight up murder things. All right, I think, yeah, Aloth is getting eaten alive by gnats. So let's drop some heals on the back row here. They're getting kind of chewed on a little bit. And Aloth, while you were being lightly nibbled on, why don't you just magic missile this guy? Wow, these bees are... What the hell was... What even was that? These bees are no joke. Holy crap. All right, Aloth is down. Let's see, get you healing. Let's get you dropping a chain heal. You guys are just... Nope, I want you to throw the hammer there. On Adair. Adair, you are not doing... Oh, no, he did. All right. Weird. Heal yourself. This fight went slightly pear-shaped. What is going on here? We're prone and hobbled and... Oh, my God. We're going to lose Swell. That never happens. I don't know how worried I am, but... You guys, you need to focus targets down. Swell heal. Ah, yeah. Swell, you're a deity. Nothing can kill you. I'm pretty sure you're invulnerable. I say moments before he goes down. He's like tanking four of these things right now. I appreciate his imperviousness, but the rest of the party needs to actually, you know, put some effort forth here before he goes down. Look at his health bar. It's like playing WoW. Everybody's health is just like flying all over the place.
Let's go.
Okay. Oh, there was a druid in there. That's where all of this horror is coming from. Yeah, okay. Yeah, there were a trio of druids in there. That explains a lot. I was like, where are all these, like, horrible effects coming from? Druids. I don't know what that was, but it was hilarious. And it screwed them more than it screwed me. Devil of Karak's gonna get smashed here in a moment, if I had to guess. One of these things is gonna get tired of her bullshit. And just smack her with its... Yep, there it goes. I was saying, just smack her with his mace and she's gonna be done. Let's see here. We could do some attribute leeching, but it's probably a little late. There we go. That was a good fight. I'm pretty pleased with that one. Oh, there's a cave up here. Nice. Mm. All right. Loot the bodies.
Mm-hmm.
Beautifully done. Okay, so we're going to camp again because 3/4 of my party just got the ever-loving shit kicked out of it. And I'm going to call it an episode. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time. I will see you all next time when the adventure continues. Until then.